While we were traveling in Portugal, we decided to make a small experiment and make this logo on the van. We wanted to try to just to attract maybe more tourist travelers or locals and to see if it will work in some way. And we found quite a big shop where they do this, and it was not very expensive, so we decided to test it. Much cash we spent. We spent like 100 euro with all the stickers and with the work. Yeah, surprisingly the work was 40 euro, but from the other point they done 2.5 hours were working with this stickers to put them on properly, to measure things. So let's say it was quite cheap.
Everything starts from a good cleaning, so you don't have any grease or dirt on the van. Then you kinda start to plan where exactly stickers will go, and those magnets are definitely cool and useful things to have. You want to be precise, so you would need also measuring tape and sticker tape. With a rubberized spatula, you're basically removing all air and any defects. Please notice that it's crucial to do it slowly, area by area, by removing a protective film from adhesive side. Our van is 10 years old and most probably it had some painting issues from the factory. It's a sort of same but other vans with this problem. Obviously you do everything from both sides. Sometimes on tricky corners you might need to stretch adhesive material, and here heat gun might help. But it won't do miracles, after we've done completely the job, we still had a gap on that corner. Then you just continue with the design by making sure that everything is straight and precise. Here is how we solve the paint problem, by putting a new piece of film on it. Repeat the same for the back doors, cut excessive stuff, remove protective layer. Up till now everything is great, but text is still missing. Putting letters on the side of the van is an easy task, which requires you to be precise with distances. Actually, I think the more simple design you have, the more precise you should be, and the more you will need to pay attention to details. In our case, everything is basically modular, printed out of single layer with only one color on it. These two letters is just on top of yellow background instead of printing black logo on yellow background. It definitely makes things cheaper. Instagram, Facebook, YouTube and QR code, which will direct you to the website. You might notice that on the logos there is a white background, and that's not ideal as you want it to be transparent or exactly the same color of the van. Finishing touch on the back doors, and that's the result.
Yeah, next time I think we do buy ourselves, just for the sake of experiment, yeah. To learn another skill.
Yeah, that would be even better, I guess. You know, if you do mistake, it's fine, because you like, okay, next time I will do it better.
But why do we want to remove is, the main reason is the van was designed as a stealthy style. It's invisible, you can't, no one even know that it's a van, that it's a camping site. And unfortunately, when we not travel, because this is a car which we're using every day, and then you have time, you travel. So since it's parked at the same spot, people see this thing all the time. Then, for example, yesterday I went to the airport, I parked my car in some street, and it was visible, people see this. If the car stays for too long, the people will kind of, ah, I know this car. If the van is completely white, people just confuse with the other white van.
So you're not ready for shyness?
No, I don't want, but the point is, that was meant to be shiny, but it's the point is, when you travel, you want a window, you want a tent, you want everything.
Everything there.
When you park back home, you don't want anything. You want your car to be invisible, no one will see that this is a camper. So it's a bit of, depends how much you travel.
So we can just remove them and put them on the side, and maybe just stick them again before the next trip.
Do you have something magnetic?
Just stick them.
It's metal, so...
I would think some, yeah.
A small tip to make, to save your money, why it was 60 euro only is because this is really simple. This is just two letters. So the guy who is doing illustrator work, He didn't spend too much time on kind of reworking on the design, because we have JPEG file. So if you want to save money, you need to have your Illustrator file. So it's basically vector design. And the font was really easy, just printed out. Where else they can save money?
Ask different people for the prices. Or do it by yourself, yeah, because it's quite easy.
I think there are two ways to go with the stickers. Or you go shiny, big thing,
all the way.
Subscribe, hey, we're traveling, hey, this is YouTube channel, something big and visible, or you just don't put them on, because this is, people don't recognize what is it.
And I think maybe some corporate van that just did, like their delivery truck or something.
Yeah, and then, for example, we removed already a couple of stickers here. There was Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, and QR code. just because I didn't like how they look, the logos. But that was the main point, like, hey, Exploration Brothers and YouTube logo, so people might go, but people not that, you know, proactive, sharp. And they don't
probably
go.
Probably you need to have like a YouTube logo like size like this.
Yeah, so make something big, something visible, then it might work and bring you some people to your channel and see. But in reality, what worked to bring our followers is saying in the video, go to the Instagram, because I feel like we're investing some...
To first to bring people to YouTube, let's say, no?
Yeah, so it's a game. I mean, there is a chicken and egg, I think. Yeah. So what do you think about the experiment?
I mean, it was quite nice just to make the design, to find the place where to print and put it on. So it was in general quite good. I'm quite happy.
I think it's time to remove this. People are curious everywhere about us, huh?
Yeah.
Important point to remove the stickers as soon as you think that they're not working is because the sun is hitting the van, and after you will have difference in colors.
Well,
I was thinking it would be easier. When you remove slowly, you have less glue staying on the van. Instead, when you just maybe pull fast, you see straight away that the glue is remaining on the van. So here we are.
You know, you recognize your van in hundreds of vans because, oh, where's the yellow spot there? Oh, here's our van, but not anymore. So I'm wrapping it around so we can use it the next time we will go traveling.
Removing the stickers is quite a painful experience. It's kind of removing something from the van, but now it's really stealthy.
It was breaking my heart.
Yeah, we still have to clean van with the cleaning product because a lot of sticky stuff on the van is still there.
Yeah, you need like adhesive remover just to remove the glue from the surface of the van.
Yeah, I hope this video was useful so you know how to put stickers on and how to remove them all.
Yeah, yeah.
And yeah, check our Instagram, maybe something interesting there, no?
Yeah, check it out for sure.
Yeah, like button is free as usual, and subscribe if you like to see more videos.
That's it, yeah.
That's it?
Yeah. Arrivederci.
Ciao.